Hello everyone and welcome, and let's take a look at a cutaway of the Abus Titalium 80-50. Bosnian Bill made that cutaway from me. Bill, thank you very much for doing that. He had to kind of destroy the padlock in order to do it, but it doesn't matter because we only want to take a look at the pins that it's featuring and also at the locking mechanism that it's featuring. Okay, see you in the next part of the video. Okay, welcome back, and let's take a look at the locking mechanism. As you can see here, the locking mechanism consists of two spring-loaded bolts, and I am pretty sure you can probably shim it because the bolts are not interlocked. So when the lock is being, even when the lock is being closed, you can still move the locking belts because they're spring-loaded and not being interlocked. Let's open the padlock and give you a look at the locking bolts. Here we got them, and they are the usual type, not the round ones, not the ball bearings. And if you can get a shim into these tight tolerances here, you could probably shim them. Maybe try it with a little oil. I don't have my own sets of shims yet, but as soon as I get one, I will try it. Let's also take a look at the plug. Let's remove the plug. And let's also take a look at the keyway restriction, which is quite restrictive, I would say. Let's take a look at it from the other side. There you go, keyway restriction. It's a different keyway restriction on the 6-pin titanium padlocks than on the 5-pin titanium padlocks. You may think now you have 7 pin chambers here, but as you can see, the 7th pin chamber has sort of a milling down that way. And this is actually the pin chamber with the pin that holds the core in place. I will show that to you now. So if we plug the core back in, and imagine we have the pin here that holds the core in place. When inserting the key and then also aligning the pins to the right height and turning the core in order to open the padlock, that pin that holds the core in place has to go somewhere, and therefore you have that milling here, and the pin can move into that milling and then also stop the core from turning, but also the rest of the mechanism will stop the core from furtherly turning. Okay, can you bypass this type of padlock? No, you can't. I've tried it with several tools, and maybe I haven't found the right tool yet, but I wasn't able to bypass it. As you can see here, Abus has inserted, I believe, probably a steel or a hardened steel pin that goes in here and reaches all the way to this position here. Let's get some light. There, can probably see, and this will prevent you from getting tools in there from at the bottom of the keyway. Okay, see you in the next part of the video where we'll take a closer look at the pins. Come to the next part of the video, and this is probably not going to be the last, I'm sorry. Let's take a closer look at the pins, but before doing that, you may have noticed that the 5th driver pin here is missing, and that is because it's still stuck in the padlock, as you can maybe see here. I wasn't able to get it out, and if I wanted to get it out, I would probably have to make another drill hole somewhere here, and but I've not done that yet. If you want to remove the core yourself on your titanium padlock, you would have to make a drill hole here at the position of the 7th pin and drill out the 7th pin that holds the core in place. But let's go on and take a look at the pins of the titanium padlock. They are all made out of brass and plated with chrome, and all these springs are made out of magnetic steel and probably also plated. So when taking a look at the key pins, number 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and here number 6, you can see that all the key pins are normal key pins. Then all the drivers, no, not all of them, we have a spool, another spool, one with a serration, but a very slightly serration, a spool, probably another one with a serration, which is still in the padlock, and here is some kind of special pin, which we are going to talk about in the next video. So, see you in the next part of the video. Hello and welcome to the next part of the video, and let's take a closer look at the pins featuring the titanium padlock. So this is this last special pin, and I can only assume or guess that it's probably some kind of anti-bump pin, as it features a huge step and it fits fully into the inner plug, so it can get the core quite stuck. Let's take a look at one of the spools and one of the serrated pins. Let's talk about them. Here we have one of the spools and one of the serrated driver pins. If my camera will finally focus. Oh, thank you. Okay, as you can see on the serrated driver pin, it only features a very slight serration. I don't think this is good. And also the, let's say, the tolerances here on the spool pin are also not that accurate, or let's say the milling is not that accurate. And let's compare these two security pins to two decent security pins out of my collection. Here we have a spool, and here we have a serrated driver pin. And as you can see here, the cuts or the millings here on that serrated driver pin are much deeper, and also the edges and the quality here on the milling of that spool is also more accurate. So if you ask me, the quality of these security pins is at question. But however, would I buy a padlock like this to secure something? Well, it depends. If you're only securing a locker in university, you could buy one of these, probably. But what else can you get for that money? For that money that this 80-50 padlock costs in Germany, I could easily get a commander lock, for example. Commander lock is a padlock that is made out of steel with a ball bearing locking mechanism that I cannot shim, and that will give me some more problems probably in picking resistance. I would go for the commander lock. First of all, these Abus padlocks are made in China. The commander lock is made in the USA. And I hope you enjoyed this presentation and this gutting of this Abus Titalium padlock. Have a nice day and have a nice evening. Take care. Bye bye.